This is the ruling class. They run this trans society and set its political and economic agenda. They are the power elite in this capitalist monarchy. They do no physical labor or resource production. This is the bourgeoisie. They profit off of the working class labor and are only concerned with preserving their capital. They are the backbone of capitalism, middle class consumers who keep the working class down. This is the working class. They are the labor force who rely upon wage labor to survive. They produce economic value for the bourgeoisie and ruling class and have no upwards mobility. Here we see the working class labor under the oppressive rule of the Emperor Murdoch. They toil away to no end as the emperor and the bourgeoisie grow richer and richer. For the working class trans, capitalism is an oppressive and limiting system. They are trapped. A particularly outraged member of the proletariat has an idea, a communist uprising. The wealth of the state would be distributed among the people and the rich upper class would be overthrown. The other working class trains listen, rapt, as a plan is made. Revolution is violent and tragic, but it is also necessary for true societal change. Any trains who don't accept the newly communist government are murdered in the name of economic freedom. The great buildings of the rich are empty as private property has been abolished. The surviving bourgeoisie works side by side with the working class, and wealth and resources are distributed in a fair and equal manner. There is no more classist oppression. The evil king lies dead at the wayside, a warning to any overly ambitious trains.